Did you watch a SmackDown show?
No, I did not. I'm going to watch that tomorrow morning.
Well, I'll tell you about it a little bit here. So if you guys did not hear, on Thursday, they announced that the main event, one of the main events of Hell in a Cell, Roman Reigns versus Rey Mysterio, was being moved to SmackDown. And day's notice, and they announced it at the beginning of the show, and apparently as we get into the ratings later, like the first and second hour did virtually the exact same audience, and as I'm sure Dave will note here, up 4% in the overnights, which I guess that's good that it's up 4%. Yeah,
interesting,
but
interesting that the cable stuff I got was down 5%, which I would think it should be up. I mean, it's logic it should be up, but I know that the numbers I got were AEW up 5, a little over 5, and WWE down a little more than 5. So that's what it was.
Well, I guess we'll see what the final numbers are, but the overnights.
The final number, they're both Nielsen, so they're more they're more in line with each other. So the final number should be up a little bit, in the Nielsen number. The number that I got, I mean, it was similar, just similar homes, similar everything, just down 5%. AEW was actually viewer wise up 10%, but the viewers watched less of the show, so it would be up only 5% overall. But Nielsen may have a different number, so whatever.
Well, the Nielsen overnight is 1.928 million, which is up 4%, and the fact of the matter is,
it should be over 2 million, but it should be up. It should be up.
It should be up, but they gave away the main event Hell in a Cell match. I mean, this should be up significantly.
It should be up 10%, honestly. It should be up 10%, and it wasn't. But it also only had one day of promotion. So, that's going to mitigate it somewhat. If they had announced it a week ago, it probably would be up more. I mean, just logically. But since they didn't decide a week before, they couldn't announce it a week before. They decided it the day before. So there you go. I mean, why? Whatever. it's like, I don't even know how to explain it other than, okay, if the idea is, but I also, since I said this yesterday, if the idea is that not that many people are going to watch Hell in a Cell, and it's all about building up Roman Reigns for a match with John Cena, and just building up Roman Reigns, and he's going to get a big win, which he did, that you would, if you put it on Fox, more people will see it. I was also told that was not the reason it was done. So it was done because it was done. They wanted the rating up, but whatever. It's hard to explain. I mean, other than it tells you that the priorities have changed with WWE, and the SmackDown rating was more of a priority than the Peacock number, or they felt that it wasn't going to add to the Peacock number, it would help the SmackDown rating, and that's probably true. I don't think any less people are watching the pay-per-view over it. And probably a few more people watched SmackDown for it. And so there you go.
Well, they went 16 minutes. And the thing about the match is they actually did give Rey Mysterio a lot in the match. But there was not a single...
Of course they would.
But there was no moment where you thought that the guy had any chance of winning whatsoever. It was just like he attacked the guy with a toolbox and a chair. And he hit him with a bunch of gimmicks early. And Roman sold a lot for him, but then, of course, he cut him off and beat him up. And Rey made a comeback there at the end and hit a lot of spots. But again, it was impossible to believe the guy would win. And then finally, Roman grabbed him and did the same thing he did to his son, which was powerbomb him over the top rope, but it was into the side of the cage and then presumably down onto a crash pad. And then threw the guy into the ring and he put him in a guillotine. And it wasn't even like, Rey fights and fights and fights. It's like he puts him in this like reverse guillotine and this dude taps immediately. And so Rey Mysterio is dead. Roman Reigns wins. Jimmy Uso comes down to the ring. And as they're celebrating, Rey starts getting to his feet. And so Roman just grabs him and he puts him in the guillotine again. And Rey taps out again. and then lies there in a heap as the show goes off the air. So he beat him, he submitted him, and then he submitted him again, and that was the main event of SmackDown.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's all about building Roman right now, so you sacrifice people. I don't see any need for doing it a second time and rubbing it in, but like I said, it's all about building Roman and Rey's, you know. I mean, look, they never, you know, I mean, that's Rey's role, you know. I mean, it's never been about Rey being the big star. And the one time that he was, Vince was against it anyway. I mean, Rey's role is to be the guy, you know, who fights, gets some offense more than you would think, but ultimately he's not going to beat the top guys. And, you know, and at his age now, I mean, it's double, you know. So, you know, I mean, beating him twice that easy, you know, kind of, you could say it weakens the tag title, and it does, but, you know, they've never had the tag title mean that much anyway, so, you know, that's not a big deal there either. So, that's just Rey's role. I mean, you know, you could say he's real popular and he's a legend and you don't do that stuff, but, you know, I mean, Vince will look at his age and that's part of it. And, you know, and even throwing out the age, I mean, Rey's not booked at that level. You know, he's paid at that level, but he's not booked at that level.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts. And also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.